Hello everyone, today we will learn the topic glycoside part 1. This slide depicts the points which we are going to discuss in this presentation. It includes general introduction, definition, examples, properties, classification, extraction method, therapeutic and general uses of glycosides, and one example of glycoside. Plants are biochemical reactors that produce array of phytochemicals. These phytochemicals can be simply classified as primary and secondary metabolites. The biochemical reaction can be simply oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis, which are just a part of photosynthetic reactions. These biosynthesis depends on highly organized structures of plant and animal cells. Now let us see what are the primary metabolites. Primary metabolites can be directly utilized in a biological system at the developmental stages of plant. Examples are carbohydrates, proteins, and fats. The first molecule what plant produce in photosynthesis is sugar. Secondary metabolites. These are secondary products or byproducts of plant metabolism which does not have primary functions. Examples include glycosides, iridoids, tannins, resins, alkaloids, etc. Glycosides are organic natural compounds present in lot of plant and some animals, which upon hydrolysis gives one or more sugar moiety along with non-sugar moiety. Here sugar is called glycon part and non-sugar is called a glycon part. Simply you can say some plant contains organic molecules along with sugar moieties are called as glycosides. Upon hydrolysis of glycosides by any acid, alkali or enzyme in presence of water results in two products. For example, salicin is a glycoside. Upon hydrolysis, it gives salicyl alcohol and glucose. This slide depicts the examples of glycoside. The first includes digitalis. Then second is senna plant, senna leaf, calmix plant, calmix stem, mustard seeds and mustard plant. Now let us have a look at properties of glycoside. All glycoside contains sugar molecule which can be monosaccharide or disaccharide. Mostly the sugar is glucose sugar, but it can be ramose or fructose. There are special deoxy sugars present in cardiac glycoside, example digitoxose and saccharose. Others are galactose and mannose. The glycoside also includes anthocyanin pigments of flowers, which are associated with the tannins, and they also show glycosidic characters. Glycosides are mostly colorless, solid, amorphous compound, non-volatile in nature, except flavonoid glycoside, which is yellow in color, and anthraquinone glycosides, which are red and orange in color. Mostly they are odorless, except saponin glycoside, which is glycyrrhizin, which has sweet odor. All glycosides, they give positive reaction for Mohler's test and Fehling's test after hydrolysis. That means first take the powder, hydrolyze it with hydrochloric acid and then carry out this test, then it will be positive. All glycosides are water soluble compounds, insoluble in organic solvents like ethyl acetate, and most of them they have bitter taste except glycyrrhizin and steatocyte. This slide depicts the classification of glycoside. They are simply classified in four categories: A based on sugar, B based on non-sugar, C based on linkage between sugar and non-sugar, and D based on therapeutic uses. Now let us see A based on sugar. Now if the glycoside contains glucose as a sugar, then they are called glucoside. Example, cenoside. If the glycoside contains rhamnose as a sugar, then it is called rhamnoside. Similarly, digidoxoside means the glycoside containing digidoxo sugar, and glucoramnoside means the glycoside containing glucose as well as rhamnose, both as a sugar molecule. Second category, B based on non-sugars, that means which type of non-sugar moiety is present in glycoside. For example, if anthraquinone structure is present, then it is called anthraquinone glycoside. Example, senna. If alcohol OH group is present, then they are called alcohol glycoside. Example, salicine. If aldehyde group is present, then they are called aldehyde glycoside. If phenol group is present, then they are called phenolic glycoside. If isothiocyanate group is present, then they are called isothiocyanate glycoside. If cyanogenic group, that is CN group, is present, then they are called cyanogenic glycoside. Third category, based on linkage. Now it includes which element is present as a link between sugar and non-sugar. For example, if oxygen is a link, it is called O glycoside. For example, phenolic arbutin. If nitrogen element is a link, it is called N-glycoside. If carbon is a link, it is called C-glycoside. For example, alloin. And if sulfur is a link, it is called S-glycoside. Example, cinegrin. Fourth classification is based on what are the uses of glycoside. If the glycoside shows the effect on cardiac muscles, they are called cardiac glycoside. Example, digoxin. If glycosides show laxative effect, they are called laxative glycosides. If they show anti-inflammatory effect, they are called anti-inflammatory glycosides. For example, alloin from aloe leaves. They are called local irritant glycoside. Example, cinegrin. They are called analgesic glycoside and antipyretic glycoside. Example, salicine. This slide tells you about extraction of glycoside. The method is called Stas-Otto method. Initially, take the crude drug powder, which should be dried powder, and pack it in a succinate extraction assembly. Now here we are using alcohol as a solvent. Set up the assembly and start it. Temperature should be below 45 degree. In this step, the enzymes get deactivated. After sufficient time, take out the RBF and take the extract in a beaker. In this, add lead acetate. It will precipitate the tannins. Filter it so that tannins are removed on filter paper. This filtrate obtained, in this pass the H2S gas, okay, and again filter it. Now concentrate this extract in a china dish. This extract is called crude glycosidic extract, which can be further purified by using fractional solubility method. Now how will we identify glycosides? These are the four important tests for identification of cardiac glycoside. First test is Liberman-Burchard test. Here take the powder, add chloroform and acetic anhydride, and slowly add sulfuric acid. You will see sap green color, so it indicates presence of steroidal glycoside. Second test is legal test. Here take the powder, add pyridine and sodium nitroprusside, It shows red to pink color. Third test is Bulgit test. Here, take the TS of drug, transverse section of drug, add sodium picrate in it. If it shows yellow or orange color to a particular part, then that part contains glycoside. Fourth test is very important, called Killer-Killani test. Here, take the powder drug plus alcohol, boil it carefully and filter. To the filtrate, add water and lead acetate. Again, filter it. Lead acetate precipitate tannins. Take the filtrate and add chloroform to it and take it in a separating funnel. Shake it very well for 10 minutes. Then slowly remove the chloroform layer and transfer it in a china dish. In this, add a glacial acetic acid and ferric chloride solution. Now take another test tube containing concentrated sulfuric acid and this glacial acetic acid containing mixture, transfer it slowly to the test tube containing sulfuric acid. At the end, you will see a reddish brown color at the junction. This indicates presence of glycoside. Now let us see therapeutic uses of glycoside. Some glycosides have antibacterial activity, so they protect the plants from bacteria and disease. Some of them act as a flavoring agent, for example vanillin and orange. You people enjoy eating vanilla ice cream that contains vanillin. Some glycoside act as a counter irritant, condiment, emetic in large doses, for example mustard seed. Mustard oil is an emetic drug. Some of them are used as laxative glycoside. Best example is senna, then rhubarb and cascara. Some glycosides are used as purgative glycoside, as well as they are very good for skin, example aloe. Some glycosides are acting as antidiarrheal, for example rhubarb. Some glycosides are used as herbal cosmetics, for example aloe. Then cardiotonic glycosides, that is digitalis and squill. And few are used as a steroidal hormone, for example diazoxide and digitalis. Here the senna leaflet is described. Its synonym is Folia senna, Alexandrian senna and Tinevalli senna. Biological source: senna consists of dried leaflets of plant Cassia angustifolia and Cassia acutifolia that belongs to family Leguminaceae. It is found in India in Tinevalli region and Ramnathpuram district. Also, it is cultivated in South Africa, Egypt, Nile region, Kordofan and Senna region. Active chemical constituents of Senna include sinoside A, sinoside B, sinoside C and sinoside D, flavanols, anthraquinone glycosides, rhein and imodine, pyrimidine A and alloimodine. Other chemical components are tinevalin glycoside, 6-hydroxymucin glycoside, salicylic acid, chrysophenic acid, volatile oils, resins, calcium and mucilage. The structure depicted here is of sinoside A. The uses of senna includes mainly this herb is used as purgative, antipyretic, cathartic and laxative. It is also used as vermifuge. It has diuretic property. Thank you very much for patient listening.